Hello students, in today's video we will study about comparing fractions. So first we will move with like fractions. As you all can see, when the denominators are same, we compare numerators. The fraction with bigger numerator is the greater fraction. I hope you all know what are like fractions. Like fractions are the fractions whose denominators are same. Now when I have more than two factors more than two fractions to compare, that time children just observe all the denominators. I could see in my example that all my denominators are same, so all these are like fraction. So in such cases, when all my denominators are same, I will compare the numerator. So it is same as your normal numbers. I can see that 2 is the smaller one. So the smallest fraction is 2 upon 9. Smaller the numerator, smaller is the fraction. So 2 upon 9, then I'll have 4 upon 9, then I'll have 5 upon 9, and finally I'll have 7 upon 9. Now children, we will see comparing fractions, comparing unlike fractions. Now I will be explaining you two cases into it. As you all can see, when the numerators are same, we compare the denominators. The fraction with smallest denominator is the greatest fraction. Now it is opposite over here. I could say that all my numerator numbers are same. So in such cases, children, you have to again observe your denominator, opposite one. But here it is opposite again. Here smaller the denominator, bigger is the fraction. That means the bigger denominator will be the smallest fraction. So among these denominators, 9 is the biggest one. So this will be the smallest fraction, 11 upon 9. Then I'll have 11 upon 6. Then I'll have 11 upon 5, 11 upon 4, and 11 upon 2. This was the case when all my numerator was equal. I cannot call it as like fractions because like fractions are only those which have the denominator same. Now case number 2, fractions with unlike numerator and denominators, what do we have to do? That means my numerators are also different and my denominators are also different. As you all know children, when I have to compare fractions, I need to have my denominators equal. So in such cases, to make them equal, I need to have a specific number that I can convert all my three denominators into that number. Now I cannot take any number randomly. For that I need to have the LCM of 7, 3 and 10. So first I will find the LCM of 7, 3 and 10. I get the LCM as 210. Now go on multiplying that 7, which is a number which will give me 210 after multiplying by 7, that is 30. Whatever I do to the denominator, I do the same to the numerator. I get the answer 120 upon 210. Then 2 upon 3 multiplied by 70 will give me 140 upon 210. And 3 upon 10 multiplied by 21 will give me 63 upon 210. I can see that all of my three numbers have now got the denominators equal. So I can now compare only the numerator. Among the three, 120, 140 and 63, 63 upon 210 is the smallest one. So I write it here. Then I have 120 upon 210 and 140 upon 210. Now let's get back to its original fraction. 63 upon 210 was nothing but 3 upon 10. 120 upon 210 was nothing but 4 upon 7, and 140 upon 210 was nothing but 2 upon 3. So this is how I compared all the unlike fraction with no numerator and no denominator same. I have to take out the LCM and then I have to go ahead. Now let's continue children. I will be explaining you few sum from your my practice time too. Can you see this sum? 35 upon 19 and 8 upon 20. Again, I can see that my denominators are not same. So I will make it same by taking the LCM. Before that, I can observe that 8 upon 20 can be reduced. It is always reduced to reduce and have your operation children, because that will help you to get your answer in an easy way and a quick way. So I have reduced 8 upon 20, I have reduced it by 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 5s are 20. Now again it's not same, so I'll be taking out the LCM of 19 and 5. Now 19 and 5 LCM gives me 95. Now the first fraction when multiplied by 5 will give me 95, and the second fraction when multiplied by 19 will give me 95. So the answers that I've got is 175 upon 95 and 38 upon 95. Now I've made my denominators same. When I compare my numerators, 175 upon 95 is greater than 38 upon 95. Let's come back to its original fraction, that is 35 upon 19 is greater than 2 upon 5, or 35 upon 19 is greater than 8 upon 20. Hello students, now let us see arranging the fractions in ascending and descending order. I have taken this example from your My Practice Time 2, question number 3. Arrange the following fractions in ascending order. This is the D one that I am showing you, that is 1 upon 7, 4 upon 14, 3 upon 35 and 9 upon 10. As you all know, to compare or to arrange the fraction in ascending order, we need to make all, since these are all unlike fractions, I need to first make it like by making the denominator same. I can make the denominator same by taking out its LCM. So all the denominator number first to be written 7, 14, 35, 10. Then I have found the LCM. I got the LCM as 70. Now my next step is I need to convert all the denominator number as 70. So 1 upon 7. 7 has to be multiplied by 10. Keep one thing in your mind, children. It is the denominator digit that decides which number should be multiplied, because it is first the denominator number that I have to convert it to the LCM number. So 7 multiplied by 10. So 7 multiplied by 10 as well as multiplied in the numerator as well as in the denominator. So I get the number as 10 upon 70. Then 4 upon 14. 14 multiplied by 5 will give me 70. So 5 is multiplied in to both the numerator and denominator, I get 20 upon 70. Then 3 upon 35, 35 multiplied by 2 gives me 70. So the whole fraction is multiplied by 2 and I get 6 upon 70. And finally 9 upon 10, 10 multiplied by 7, the whole fraction to be multiplied by 7 and I'll get 63 upon 70. So finally I have made all of my four fractions like fractions. So now I can arrange it. Arrange it by only comparing the numerators. The smallest numerator is 6 upon 70, then I have 10 upon 70, then I have 20 upon 70, and then I have 63 upon 70. So let's come back to its original fraction. 6 upon 70 was 3 upon 35 is the smallest one. Then I have 1 upon 7, then 4 upon 14, and then 9 upon 10. It is similar as comparing the fraction, children. Only the thing is we have to arrange it in the ascending order. Now I will take one example of descending order. Same My Practice Time 2, question number 4. I have taken the F1. 29 upon 30, 3 upon 5, 11 upon 15, 7 upon 10. The steps are same. To make all the denominators same, I need to make it like by taking out its LCM. The LCM gives me 30. If I see the first fraction is already 30, I need not have to multiply it by any other number than 1. The second one, 5 multiplied by 6 will give me 30. So I have multiplied the whole fraction with 6. Then the second one is 2. 11 upon 15 multiplied by 2, 22 upon 30, and 7 upon 10 multiplied by 3 will give me 21 upon 30. Now I have made the denominators equal. Now I will be arranging the number in descending order. So the biggest one is 29 upon 30, then it's 22 upon 30, 21 upon 30, and 18 upon 30. Let's come back to its original fraction. 29 upon 30 is nothing but 29 upon 30 itself. Then 22 upon 30 is nothing but 11 upon 5. 21 upon 30 is 7 upon 10. And 3 upon 5, that is 18 upon 30, is 3 upon 5. So this is the way I have arranged the number in fractions in descending order.